Welcome to this session on linear equations in two variables. In our previous video, we learned how to represent linear equations in two variables graphically. Let's move a step ahead and learn about equations of lines parallel to the x-axis and the y-axis. Friends, we know that a line is made up of infinitely many points. So let's start by considering a point. Can you tell where will the point 1, 0 lie on a graph? Let's see. Here, the x-coordinate is 1 and the y-coordinate is 0. Hence, this point will lie on the x-axis. Where will the point 2, 0 lie? This will also be on the x-axis. Similarly, 5, 0, minus 1, 0, minus 3, 0 will all lie on the x-axis. Will point 4, 3 also lie on their x-axis? No. And what about minus 3 and 2? Even this point won't lie on their x-axis. Hence, we can say that the points whose y-coordinate is 0 or which is in the form of x0 will lie on the x-axis. The line formed by all the points in the form of x0 is the x-axis. Can you tell the equation of this line or what will be the equation of x-axis? Let's find out. We know that y-coordinate of all the points lying on the x-axis will be 0. That means x-axis is the line where y is equal to 0. And this itself is the equation of the x-axis. We can even write it this way. 0 multiplied by x plus 1y is equal to 0. Friends, what will be the coordinates of the points lying on the y-axis? 0, 1, 0, 3, 0, minus 2, 0, minus 4, or we can say that it will be in the form of 0, y. That means y-axis is the line with all the points lying on it having their x-coordinate as 0, that is, x is equal to 0, which itself is the equation of y-axis. We can write this as 1x plus 0y is equal to 0. We got two equations which represent two lines, the x-axis and the y-axis. Now, if we compare the two equations with the general form of linear equation in two variables, we get constant terms as 0. And since the constant terms are 0 here, the two lines pass through the origin. Friends, now, how will the graph look if instead of y is equal to 0 and x is equal to 0, it was y is equal to c and x is equal to c, that means a constant term or any number? Now let's assume x as 5, which can be written as x minus 5 is equal to 0. The solution of this linear equation in one variable will be x is equal to 5, which lies on the number line here in the form of a point. Now, if we write this in the form of linear equations in two variables as x plus 0y minus 5 is equal to 0, then we will get infinite solutions. And 5, 0 will be one of the solutions, which will lie on the x-axis. 5, 2, 5, 3, 5, minus 1 are some more solutions. Now let's plot a graph considering these points. We will get a line which will cut the x-axis at 5, 0 and is parallel to the y-axis. Friends, one point to be noticed here is that all the solutions are in the form of 5, n here. N is a real number. Now let's assume the value of y as 4 and also write it in the form of linear equations in two variables as 0 multiplied by x plus 1y minus 4 is equal to 0. Can you tell how will the graph of this equation look like? You may pause the video and think of the answer. All the solutions of this equation is in the form of n, 4. And the line formed by this equation will cut the y-axis at 0, 4. And will be parallel to the x-axis. Friends, that's it for today. Today we learned about equations of the lines parallel to the x-axis and y-axis. See you in our next session. Thank you.